Hey, Coach Dan Gordon here, and I'm going to show you how I lay out my ebooks and walk through the whole process of it. So now that you've completed your manuscript, and if you have some design skills, you can use this exact process to lay out your ebook. By the way, I'm making this video for people who have used my process called Let's Write an Ebook. And if you haven't used that, you really should, because I reverse engineered my entire process for ebook writing and turned it into a little system that is free for you to use. Just go to this link. So let me show you how I built this. And actually, before I do that, I'm going to show you that I've actually built two of them. This one is for tablet, desktop, and laptop computers, and this size is for cell phones. The reason being is that if someone is trying to read this tablet version over here on the left on a cell phone, it's not going to fit very well. It's going to be really hard to read. So I made this version and figured out a really simple way to go from the tablet version to the cell phone version fairly quickly. And what I've done, that you can see over here in the lower left-hand corner for both of them, is a little button that says click for book in cell phone format, and over here click for book in tablet format. So if someone is looking at the tablet format on their cell phone or vice versa, they can just click that little button and it'll pop right in the correct format. And of course, I'll show you how to do that as well. So let's dive in. And I'm going to show you how to build your ebook in Keynote. Now, if you don't have a Mac or you don't know Keynote, you can probably do it in PowerPoint. I'm not an expert at PowerPoint, but all these principles should work. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to open up a new document. And let's just get rid of this. And then you'll need to size it down correctly. So over here on Document, you can see the size of this is set to 1536 by 2048. So you just go to Document, Widescreen, Custom Size, 1536 by 2048, and boom, we have the correct size. So as you can see over here, there's 8 pages. So if you just hit Option and drag, it'll duplicate it. So now I select both of them, Option, drag. Whoa, now I have 4. Select 4, 8, and I have my 8 pages ready to go. I'm just going to save this. I'll call it ebook template. And by the way, Keynote doesn't autosave, so you want to continually save this as you do it. So I'm just going to grab this little bar on top, paste that over here, and it's just sitting there right up at the top. So to make your own bar, it's super simple. You just go up here to Shape, grab that little box, and now this thing is sized. You can just click on Format, Arrange. You can see it's 1538 by 24. So if I just plug that in, have that exact same size. And of course you can color it any color that you want. Just hit Style, as much colors here, and change it, or you can create your own color as you go. Fun. Next, I'm going to grab my picture, paste it in, and I'm going to right click and then send it back. So now you can see that little bar shows up. By the way, you can always use Show Object List, and once you get a lot of things on here, it can be hard to grab the things that you want. So you can just use the object list to grab the right thing. I'll show you a little more of that in a minute. I'm gonna close this out. And by the way, if you don't have a series of headshots like I have, you can really use any image that you want as your cover image, just as long as it somehow represents the idea of your book. If you don't know where to get images, don't do a Google image search. You'll end up downloading a copyrighted image and somebody will find you and sue you. I've heard a lot of horror stories about that. So what you can do is go to my favorite site, which is freepics.com. And just like the name says, you can find some free picks. So like if I were going to do business coach, all right, so I might be able to find, like, that's not too bad. Like that image there could fit in there pretty well. But we're just going to move ahead with what I have. Next, I'm going to show you how I do the headline. So I'm just going to grab that, put it over here. And so this is a font called BW Stretch. And obviously you can use any font that you want, but BW Stretch, you can do a search for it and download it. It's a free font. But let's say that your headline doesn't fit like this one does. By the way, I like to separate it into two lines. Just visually, it's interesting. But let's say that you called your book 10 Tips for Choosing an Awesome Business Coach. So clearly that's not fitting. So I would just shrink it down a bit. Maybe that's too small. So I'm going to go under this little gear here and under character spacing, I'm going to make it a little tighter. Do a -2, then up that. So now that gets to be higher again. And just so you know, this little white part here, I got by just going under shape, grabbing this and stretch it out to whatever shape that you want. But this is 1027 by 150. So if I just went to here and did 1027 by 150, boom, that's the correct size. So that's how you can do that. Actually, it's 159. I resize that. And then this lower box is 1027 by 210. And these are my corporate colors. So that's why it is what it is. I have this sized at 184, but again, up and down. And I put that little asterisk there because as you can see over here, there is a little subhead. I think it makes the book a little more fun, interesting, and whimsical to have a fun little subhead. So the reason that I have this asterisk as its own little thing here is because when I tried to make the asterisk here, it's too big. I just didn't like it. I just thought this looks nicer. So I created this as its own little box. And this thing is 120 points. Next, let's take a look at that subhead. I'll bring that one over. And this is a font called Summer Festival. And also that is downloadable and it's 92 point. Same thing with this asterisk. I made that its own little box because it's not sized well. I'll show you. See, that's way too small. Now, the other thing I did here is I added a tiny little drop shadow just to separate this out. So to add a drop shadow to that, you go up here under style and there's the drop shadow. So if I turn it off, you can see, whoa, it really fades into the background. And so I have it set to blur at 10%. I don't have any offset, which puts it like down like that. And I have it at opacity at 100%. That gives it just enough of a little shadow to make it pop. Over here, I have my logo, and this is a PNG format logo, which means that you can see through it. If it were a JPEG, it would just be a square. So it's great if you have your logo in a PNG format, or you can get it in that, or you can convert it from JPEG to PNG and knock out the background. Right. Anyways, you can see this is sized to 270 by 339, but I'm sure your logo is going to be in a different format. And yes, I did add the drop shadow in Photoshop. Doesn't look like you're going to add a drop shadow to a PNG file in Keynote. This is the descriptive text. Gives a little more info on what the book is about. And again, this is BW Stretch. This is at 73. I have the lines, spacing set to 1.4. Gives it a nice little spacing. And again, I have a drop shadow on it. And because without it, it fades in the background too much. This is set to 6 and 0, just like the other one is. And that's that. I like to put "written for you" by Coach Dan Gordon. Seems like it's a little more personal than just a "written by." And this is 45 points. I have this Latto is the font style. And see that semi-bold. And the U is bold. Lines are set to 1.2. And then down here at the bottom, I just recreated this little bar at the top. So, and I have two of them. So grab these and I'll bring them over to show you how that works. So these are the same size as this. So you can just duplicate it. And this is in the Arrange tab. It's 1538 by 17. Then the position is minus 1 point by 1880. This is the same size. This is position minus 2 by 2026. Now there's a little white box behind it, which I'll bring over. And so if I just go send back, whoop, that disappears. So I could always just then now click on the picture and click that send back. But another way to do that, bring that to front. Let's bring back up object list. And this thing right here is this rectangle. So I can just bring it down this way and it just pops right into place. So if you want to move things up and down in terms of the layering, you can just grab and drag here. It's always an easy way to do that. You can also bring this up by, I think it's just Command L, Shift Command L. Okay. And then I'm going to bring these elements over. Okay, this first thing, this is just a little box that I made by going to shape and grabbing this one. Let's see, the size of this is 198 by 105. And by the way, you do not have to make yours look like mine. Just showing you what I do, it might be a good starting point. And as you can see, it just looked too pill shaped. So this little dot there, you grab that and you can change the radius, which is kind of nice. To change the color, you go to style, and under fill, you can just grab this, or you can click that little button there, and this thing pops up, and you can just use the sliders to change the color. Since I'm using white, and then I have a little bit of a border around it. So what I have a 5-point border, what that is. And then to put the text in, I just double click in there. And as you can see, it's a little too big, way too big. So this font size is Latto 22. So if I did that, and to do the text color, just click here. And just for the moment, I'll do that and just typed in. And you can make that bold. And so now you can see that I added a link to it. In order to do that, you just click on it and hit Command K. And it brings this up. You want to click on where it says slide, go to web page, and then you would put in the link. So for me, I have these stored on my own server. So that's the link there. But you can put any link there if you store it on your Google Drive, Dropbox, anything. I always like a really short URL because when I share it, it's easier to share. So for instance, this URL, if I copy that out and just pop it over here, dge.bz, that is my server, and coach-ebook-sell.pdf. So that's my naming convention. And so coach ebook sell, that means it's the ebook about coaching, and sell means that when they click on it, they get the cell phone format. And I think, yeah, I added a little bit of a shadow to this, which we see under here, style, drop shadow, 12 point blur, and opacity 24%. I didn't want it overpowering. That looks kind of ugly. Then I added my copyright info. To text, this font style is BW stretch, same as this over here. It looks a little bit different because I use upper and lowercase. And you just want to put in copyright and a little copyright symbol in the year. And put in your name or the name of your company and all rights reserved. And then over here, I have a link to my website. Always nice to have. So that is how to set up your cover page. Moving right along. So over here, this is the intro page. And again, you have all of this stuff because you have already done the Let's Write an Ebook process. And if you haven't, go again to this link. So I'll bring this over first. And the way this is set up, this little item here is called the drop cap, and you can set up right here. So you can turn it off and back on again, and there's all kinds of different styles. That's the style I'm using right there. You can use that style, that style, that style. That's my favorite style. And you can, the lines and characters mean that I can have two characters as a drop shadow, or a number of them, but I just like the one. And then lines means how many lines tall it is. That's 3 lines, 4 lines, 5 lines. Let's just go back to 3. And then this is Latto, which I use throughout the book. By the way, this size is 1257 by 747. That's the width and the height. And the position is 139 points X by 62 Y. And it's 45 points and 1.5 line spacing. The thing that I like to do in my text is with my ebook, and I don't do this when I write like a paperback book, but add a little flair to the layout. So you'll notice I do a mix of italic, bold, and bold italic. So as I'm reading this to myself, I'm thinking, if I were just speaking this, how I would express it. So like, outstanding, working with a great business coach will open up your mind to exciting new ways, you know? So as you read through it, you want to think about bold italic to emphasize different words. And to do that, I just double click on a word. And with this, I can just hit Command B for bold, or I for italic, or B then I. There you go. Not too complicated. What is a little complicated are these. I'm going to drag this over here. And this is group, so I'm going to ungroup it. And as you can see, this is made up of a couple different fonts. This is Lado Black, which is the same font as this. And then this is again Summer Festival, which we saw over here on the cover page. Now you don't have to do it this way. I'll admit it, it's a bit of a pain, but I just really like the way that it looks. So it takes a little longer for my team to design it this way, or if I knock out the book, which is I did the first one. And so let me just give you the specs on this. This is 48 Lado Black. This is Summer Festival 140. By the way, I have the line set to one. And in order for this to work, you have to have a Summer Festival word on each line. So for instance, if I didn't have that there, then it looks terrible. So like if the word grow was just in Lado Black. So you have to decide which word you want on which line. And then I always put my name underneath it so people know it's my quote. And so the way that I do this is I derive these little quotes out of this text up here. So hiring a coach is the fastest way to grow your income and achieve great new success. It doesn't exactly say that up here. So it's like, you know, working with a great business coach will open your mind to exciting new ways of achieving success and increasing income. Well, that's way too much to squeeze into here. So I pared it down and I like this little quote to be no more than like 18 words. This is 16. And then this graphic here, send that back. I got this off of, once again, Free Picks. And over here, I just click vector. And I think I probably just typed in the word business coach and scrolled through it till I found something that was pretty good. Like that one's decent. And then just popped it in. You don't have to have a graphic there, but I think it looks a lot better than just that. You know. And then over here on the bottom. So this little bar is just like these over here. Now on this page and throughout most of the book, this footer down here stays the same, mostly. So on the second page again, I want to give them another opportunity to switch to the cell phone format if they're on a cell phone and they're looking at it on a tablet format. And then these, you can't see them because they have the links. I'm going to get rid of the links and see what they look like. There we go. So these are just social media icons that I downloaded, stuck in there. That is my website. And then to add the social media links, you just click on it, you hit Command K, and just like we did before, you go to web page and you just pop the link in there. By the way, once you pop it in there, you don't have to click save or anything. You just click on the next one. So again, this is a footer that I have on most of the pages just like this. One of the other nice things about Keynote is that when you paste things over from one page to another, it'll put it in exactly the same place. Now, for pages 3 through 7, and I'll bring this over. So now it says click to connect with Coach Dan. And here is where I put my Calendly link. So it gives people a lot of opportunities as they're reading it to think, hey, I'd really like to talk with Coach Dan. And there it is right at the bottom. And so I'm just going to paste this on each of these pages, except for the last one, and then go back and make it page 2, page 3, 4. You can't auto number it, but it's only 8 pages. So, you know, deal. Okay. Also, I now have a header, which is that. So it's the title of the book. And so I just took this and popped it in here, 10 tips for choosing a great business coach. Let me ungroup this and I'll show you how I made this. This is one text box. And to bring up a text box, I don't think I covered that. You just click that and the word text comes up. And so you just click inside of it, 10 tips. And then this is BW Stretch. So you just go over to style, text. And this is in book face. So I'll go there and there you go. So I have this set to 52. And obviously this changes when the book title is a little larger, a little smaller. But generally, like for this underline here, by the way, if something is on top of it, like this is on top of the underline, yeah, I can bring up the objects list, but I'm just going to click and drag and it'll select both that line and that box. And then I'm going to hit shift and click on the box and it unselects. And now I just have that. So this little line is 13, 15 wide by 4 points high, and it's positioned at 111X by 127Y. I like this size, and so anything that I do, I'm just going to keep these sizes such that they will fit on that line. So I put the name of the book there and the subhead there and just sort of go back and forth until I get the sizing looking good. In other words, Like if this was a lot bigger and this was a lot smaller, it would fit, but it just looks terrible. So you want to, again, just sort of monkey around with it until you get a really nice size that's pretty similar. And again, once you have that done, you just can copy it and then go to each page and paste it, and it'll paste at the exact right place. Nice going, Apple. So now we're going to put in the first tip and text. So this is again BW stretch, that's at 65. Sometimes I call this tips, tools, ideas, or sometimes I just number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know. But I'm calling this 10 tips, so it's obviously tip 1. And you want to keep these headlines fairly short. Don't make the headlines 2 lines. You can get across the idea without a lot of text, which again, you should already have from having done the let's write an ebook process. So again, this is 65 points. This is Latto and it's regular. But then again, like I said, I use italics, bold, and bold italics. I tried to do at least one different face per line. And it just breaks up the monotony if it just looked all like that. That's kind of boring, more interesting. So tip 1 goes right there, and I'll tell you where I place this under arrange. No, it's 1249 width by 78 high, and it's at 157x by 214 wide. This text box underneath it is 165, positioned at 165x by 313y, and the width is 187. And you can't set the height because whatever you write, it will increase the height of the box. And just so you know, I set this to here under text and style. As you can see, you can set this to align the text to the top, the middle, or the bottom, which you can't really see right now, but I just always align it to the top just to keep everything uniform. And the spacing is 1.4 lines. And there's not a lot of text here. Don't overcomplicate this for yourself. Just keep it one simple idea per tip. Now, usually, I'll bring this over. This little quote is derived from tip 1. So what I usually do is the quotes are the odd tips, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. This time, I'll bring this over, I derived it from tip 2. The reason is I just couldn't find a decent small quote that really encapsulated this idea. So I used the lower one. And again, this is really simple. You know, all you have to do is once you have this in here, you can click option and drag. And if I hold the shift down while I'm dragging, see how I'm moving this side to side, it doesn't budge. So it'll just drop it down perfectly. And now it's really nicely aligned. But let's say that didn't happen and it was like that, or maybe that's like that. What you can do is grab these two, grab that and that, and you can command click or right click as they call it. Sorry, control click, and do align objects left, and boom, it'll all go there. Then if you just drag it back and forth a little bit, you see how that line shows up? That's telling you that it is centered on the page. See how the line goes all the way down to the bottom. And also it's cool, you can see underneath that top line and the bottom line, there's a little arrow. What that's telling you is that the top of the text box and the bottom of the text box are equidistant from those lines. It's really something. Keynote has a lot of great layout little hacks inside of it. And so this is the same deal. Latto 85, Summer Festival 160. And of course, as you can see, this is in black and this is in same color as this font. And of course, now, you know, we would make this tip 2, and you would just type in there whatever your second tip is, and then start typing here, and this is aligned properly. So now I'm going to grab all of this, copy, and then paste it into here. And so now I have something of a template to do the rest of my book. So now I'll just change this to tip 3. And pop in whatever that tip is, and then put my text in there. Change this based on something that I pull out of this text up here, and change this and this. So we'll just pop these into here. Okay, which takes us all the way to page 8, and that is the bio page. So I'm gonna bring these things over one at a time. Oh, actually, yeah, the bio page does have, at least in tablet format, the same headline, which is the name of the book and the subtitle. Then I'll bring this over. Again, you should have already written this in your Let's Write an Ebook process. So this I made, and you can see it has a little shape here because I pop in my headshot. What a handsome fella. And so to create this, so I didn't have to work with the runaround on this, which is kind of a pain. Let me show you what I did. I took a box, just a box like this, and this is sized to 1353 by 776. And I'm gonna, under style, under color fill, do no fill. Now I'm gonna double click in here, and then that will pop in the little bar. Now I've typed something, but it's in white, can't see it, and it's in the wrong font. So now I've created the right box size. I just stuck some font in there for a placeholder. Now I'm gonna show you how to cut a notch out of this. So you can drop your headshot in there and make it really easy. So I'm gonna right click into this box and do make editable. And so I'm gonna hold down the option key. And as you can see, a little plus shows up there. I'm gonna put that here and put that there. So just holding down the option and I clicked and that put that there. It's still in editable and whoa, that's all messed up. So we wanna set these to being corner dots, not curvy dots. And by the way, if you click outside of this, it's going to go right back to being uneditable. So you just right click in again and go to make editable. And now I'm going to click on this dot. I'm going to right click on it and do make sharp point. And then same thing here, make sharp point. And let's see, is this, I'll make that a sharp point. Now that works perfectly. And now I can just line it out the way that I want. So let me just copy and paste this text in here just to hold it. So now this is really simple, just fits in there like a glove. If I wanted to change it a bit, just go back in here and click it, make editable, and then I'm gonna shift on that and highlight it. And now you can see both of those are highlighted, and now I can drag it down and both will drag down. If only, if only one of them is highlighted, if I drag, it would do something like that. We don't want that. So I'm gonna highlight both of them and I'm gonna hold down the shift because that will keep it pretty well just going up and down, not side to side. Same thing here. I'm going to highlight that, but now all three of them, so I'm going to shift click on this, and now I can drag this back and forth. And so I can make this exactly the size that I want it. I'm going to make it really snug and fit right up against my picture. There we go. Okay. Now that's actually a little too close. If I was designing this to start with, the word while and the picture a little too close, I could... See, now this is on top of that picture, so I'm going to right click and just click send it back. And now I can grab this. I can move that out a little bit, or if I wanted to, I could go back to make editable, shift click on that to unselect it, that in, and then that looks a little nicer. But just so you can see it the way that I created it, there we have it. Now with this, I did this paragraph a little bit differently. I have something that I really wanted to emphasize. So I made this a bold italic and 44 points, whereas the rest of this is 37 points. And the spacing on this is a little bit different. This is 1.4 point spacing. And because it's multi-paragraph, whereas these are just single paragraphs, I set the paragraph to 22 points. Just add some nice spacing in between it so the words aren't smashed together. Now here's a little thing that I made that people can click on to book an appointment with me. And just like back here and on all of these pages that click to connect with Coach Dan, this is going to be the same link. Why do I have all these links? Because you want to give people an opportunity on every page to connect with you. So I'm going to ungroup this and show you how I made it. This is its own text box. This is its own box, and as you can see, I shaped it by going, creating this, doing something like that, and doing that. So this size, just so you know, is 454 width by 152 height. And this picture of me is something I created in Photoshop, and I added a little white border around it. And so it gives a kind of a cool look to this guy. And so once I put all these elements together, and by the way, this font is Latto Medium 30, spacing 1.1. Then I selected all of these, not that, right click and did group. And once it's grouped, then I can go Command K and add a web page to it. And in there, I put in my Calendly link. I talked a little bit about Calendly in the Let's Make an Ebook process. Really encourage you to use Calendly or some kind of calendar scheduling program that will make it easy for people to connect with you. The other thing that I have on here, I have an app, so they can click here to download my badass entrepreneur app. But if you don't have an app, you can just have your link there. And then I also have a little quote, and this quote, unlike the others, is not derived from this up here. It's something that I say and actually say quite a bit. So I popped it in there, seemed to make sense. So in your process of let's write an ebook, you will have created a quote and you want to put it there. Now you may remember back here with these social media buttons. I also put those here to make them a little bit bigger, a little easier to click. And the footer that I use here is also a little bit different. I put the copyright here at the bottom, a link to my website, even though there's one there. I put my logo in there, which isn't on any of the other pages, but it is, of course, on the cover page. Of course, I don't need the social media icons because they're right there. And then page 7. And that's it. Not that complicated. So let me show you how to turn this into the cell phone format. Now, you don't have to do nearly as much moving stuff around as you might think. So just like I did with this one, I'm going to create a new document in this size. So again, you could click document up there, and this is 1242 by 2208. So here, custom slide size, 1242 by 2208. Now, unlike the tablet template, this is 14 pages. So I'm just going to duplicate, copy all, option drag, 4, thing, 8, 16. Let's knock a couple out. Okay, great. So here's what we're going to do. Well, first, we're going to save it because that's a great idea. Now, I'm just going to grab all of this. I'm going to copy this all and paste it over here. Now, as you can see, it's not perfectly sized, but it's not too bad, is it? I'm going to scoot this over a little bit, bring my logo in. Now on this, I put this on 2 lines and we'll make that, we'll center that, bring this down a bit. So now I make this box 1255 by 183. Go up to the arrange tab, 1255, 183. Now with this, I make this square because I want it to be immediately obvious that it's a little bit different than the other one. We're going to up the size of this under format text. It's 29. And now in tablet format, and I'm going to increase the border to 7. There we go. Now it pops a little bit more. I'm going to drag this down here and that there. But as you can see, it wasn't that difficult. Now we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to grab all of this over here, except for the footer for now, and just paste it in. And all we really have to do is move this in a bit, drop this down, just kind of work it out. There we go. Center these fellas. And then I'm going to bring the footer over, paste it in, and see what happens. So to make this work for cell phone, I'm going to bring this up a little bit, go back and grab this. We want that on the first 2 pages. I have to make it a little bit smaller. Wow. Now I'm going to get rid of the copyright because there just isn't really enough room for everything that I want to do here. I'm going to grab the page number, move that over. And by the way, to increase and reduce the size here, I'm just hitting Shift Command and the greater than and less than signs on the keyboard. And these can also be a little bit bigger. So I'm going to select them all and group, and then I can make them larger. And then I'm going to ungroup. I'm going to show you a little trick. So let me get this out of the way. I'm going to move that just like that. And then I'm going to highlight all of them, right click, go distribute objects horizontally. And it lines them out really well. And then I'm also going to align objects to the top just to make sure they're all in the way that I want them. Oh, and we'll move them over a little bit. By the way, you can move it over just using the arrow keys on your keyboard. And if you hold down the shift and hit the arrow keys, it'll move it a little bit more. So there we have it. Now, once again, I can just grab this footer and not these guys and just go page to page and pop them in. And all I have to do as I go through this is just change the page numbers. You get the picture. I'm not going to do them all. Okay, so back to our tablet layout. I'm just going to grab the first tip and the quote. I'm going to copy and paste it in. Now this text up here is way too small. It'd be very hard to read that on a cell phone. So for the headline, I'm going to click the format, style, and text. This is going to be now 100. And the font is going to be bold. The spacing is 1.1 and we're going to center it. And now this text is 55. We're going to keep all the formatting. We're just going to change it to 55. And the other change is we're going to increase the spacing a little bit to 1.5 and move it in just a bit. All right, that's a nice layout. So just so you know, I have this set so it's edge to edge, this box, and it's very nicely centered. This box, we go to arrange, the size is a width of 1041. The position is 121 by 436. And as you remember, I didn't have to change the font size on this. This width is 1066 and the position is 88 by 1432. Now for the next page, because it doesn't have a quote, we're just going to grab the two paragraphs. And again, this goes to now 100 and bold and centered and 1.1 here. And I'm going to move this in just a little bit. And that looks a little nicer. And this is 55 now and 1.5. I'm going to move that in a little bit. And there you have it. And so you just go through copying over each page from your tablet version. This is, of course, the third one. So you'd copy the headline, the text, and the quote. And then on the page after that, you just do the headline and the text. So that continues all the way down till we get to page 13 and 14, or page 12 and 13. So in this one, we'll do this page 12, and I'll show you what we're going to do with this. Oh, and by the way, just to back up a bit, remember these first two pages has click for book in the different format. Then we go to connect with Coach Dan. I'm going to delete that and copy it over from tablet version. And we're going to make this 23. And just a little bit bigger and bold. And we'll just replace that here by deleting that and hitting paste. And we can do that all the way through. So here we are on page 13 or page 12. And I'm going to go back to the tablet version. And I'm going to grab the text and my picture. And obviously this doesn't fit like the other did. So I'm changing this text to 55. And now, of course, we have to go back and make this editable. So I'm going to highlight that and shift click, bring it down some, and highlight that, shift click, bring that over so it fits in. We're getting there. And then I can increase the size of the picture. So this takes a little bit of back and forth. You need to work with it a bit just to get the size and the layout the way that you want it. And I'll show you the final that I do. This, which looks like that. And again, this is set to 55. The spacing is 1.5 and after paragraph is 22. And that gives a very nice layout. Now there's not enough room to put in both the Calendly link, my app, and all of the social links. So with this, we're splitting this bio page up that was just one page on the tablet version into two pages on the cell version. So with this, because it looks kind of squat there, I'm going to increase the size of it a little bit, and then I'm going to ungroup it, and I'm going to extend this out. And I'm going to increase the size of this to 46. And I'm going to grab it all and right-click and group it. And now I can pop that link back in by hitting Command K on web page and just popping the link in right there. So then the very last page, and again, don't forget to click save. So throughout this, then the cell version, I'm not putting the title in at the top like I did with the tablet version. It would compete too much with that headline. But I am going to put that in on the last page. So you can just copy that over from the tablet version. And it's pretty close. So I just want to drop this down a couple point sizes and this a couple point sizes and scooch it over, group that, and then select them all. I'm going to hit Align Center, and that'll just center it out. Now I'm grabbing my quote that was on the last page of the tablet version, and I'm sticking that up at the top. Then I have a picture of myself in a round format, and Keynote has kind of a cool way of doing that. I'll show you how that works. Make this a little larger. Then I'm going to go up to Shape and grab the circle and make it the same width as that. Then I'm going to grab both of these. Go to Format, Image, and do Mask with Selection. And boom, it pops it right in there. Now, if I want to move that around, I can just double click inside and scoot me around. Now, I did this part in Photoshop. If you're not a Photoshop person, I don't know what to tell you. But if you want a circular picture of yourself like that, that's how you do it. And then I add a link to my Badass Entrepreneur app. And in the tablet version, we had this. Pull these out, text, and make it 55. And now we're going to make these larger. And just like we did before, I group them. I'm going to click Shift Command less than sign so I can see all of these. I'm going to ungroup them. And then again, Keynote's really nice in making it easy. I just have to drag this over, and it just sort of locks in right underneath the Facebook icon. Grab these others, bring them over, Instagram under LinkedIn, website under YouTube. And now I'm going to right click, do align, do distribute horizontally, just to make sure that they're aligned properly. And they are, they look good. I can bring these down just a bit. And I'm going to move them around until that center line appears. That means that they're centered. And again, because I have all of the social media links there, I don't have to do this footer. So I just make the footer look like this. I put in my copyright, my website, and the page number. So that's how to turn your manuscript into two really nice layouts, one for tablets and one for cell phone. Now, if you think this is a bit beyond you, and it is for a lot of people, I've created a really simple way to get your manuscript turned into a very good looking professional layout, just like I have here by my design team. I can't tell you the number of compliments and clients I've gotten just by people who have downloaded my ebook, who've booked appointments with me, and tell me that the primary reason was because the ebook looked and read so nicely. Having something like this offers you a ton of credibility, whereas most people have ebooks that don't look a whole lot different than just a Microsoft Word document. Having something like this projects you as a thought leader in your industry. I just can't say enough how important it is to have well-designed, professional-looking media with links inside of them that take people directly to setting up appointments with you. That's what my design team can do for you, and I'm banking a lot quicker and a lot better looking than you could probably do it on your own. And because we do a lot of these, it allows me to price it very reasonably because I want to help you create some very badass looking materials. Just go to the link, it's on your screen, or if you're watching this on YouTube or Facebook or LinkedIn, click the link to have your book designed by my team. Be an honor to help you. I'm Coach Dan Gordon. Thanks so much for watching this. Hope it's been helpful.